Student friends, in yesterday's lecture, we discussed about the IV characteristics of PN junction diode. That is, current voltage characteristics, which are nothing but a graph of current flowing through the PN junction diode against voltage developed across the PN junction diode. We studied the circuit diagram that is used to plot the characteristics of PN junction diode. We studied two types of characteristics. One is a forward characteristics and second one is a reverse characteristics. We concluded that by observing those particular graphs, we can get how PN junction diode is going to work. After that, we have defined the terms static resistance of PN junction diode and also dynamic resistance of PN junction diode. Also, we have studied how those parameters are calculated by using the IV characteristics. Then we have studied how diode is going to act as a capacitor. We have compared the action of PN junction diode with the capacitor. Then we have studied the diode equation. It is a mathematical equation that gives the working of PN junction diode. And we have interpreted the terms used in that particular equation. Dear students, that's all about the simple PN junction diode. Now we are going to study here onwards the special diodes. The first special diode which we are going to study, and that is known as Zener diode. Student friends, we know that generally PN junction diode is used in forward bias condition because it conducts the current only in forward bias condition, but in reverse bias condition it doesn't conduct the current. Now in this particular study of Zener diode, we are going to make use of the reverse bias aspect of the PN junction diode. We know that when PN junction diode is connected in reverse bias condition, ideally it doesn't conduct the current because as it goes on increasing the reverse bias applied voltage, the width of depletion layer increases. Hence, the junction resistance becomes more, barrier potential will become more, and that's why it doesn't conduct the current. But practically, when applied voltage becomes equal to the breakdown voltage, that means while explaining the reverse bias working of the PN junction diode, I told that jastata anlaki tutta. According to same statement, we can say if you increase the supply voltage much more, then the junction will break down. By breaking the junction, the minority charge carriers which are present in P region as well as N region will start conducting the little bit amount of current in microampere range. We know that, already studied that. Friends, if the reverse breakdown voltage of the PN junction diode is made very sharp and distinct, means at that particular reverse voltage only, it is going to start conducting the current. If this condition is achieved, then and then only we can say it has a very sharp and distinct breakdown voltage. Sharp means exactly for same value of applied external voltage. Distinct means be specific only for that particular value. Then it is possible for us to construct the new diode, and that new diode we can call it as it is the Zener diode. That means Hence, some modifications are done in the simple p-n junction diode, especially in a doping concentration, if those are being changed, so that that diode, when connected in reverse bias condition, possesses very sharp and distinct breakdown voltage. That new diode so created is known as the Zener diode. This is because this effect has been discovered by Clarence E. Zener in 1938. To honor him, the name Zener is given, and hence that diode, which has a very sharp and distinct breakdown voltage, is called as Zener diode. Student friends, I remember that Zener diode is always used in a reverse bias condition. It is not used in forward bias condition. This Zener diode works either with the Zener effect or avalanche effect. Student friends, when the breakdown voltage of the p-n junction diode in reverse bias mode is made very sharp and distinct, we get Zener diode. Very simple, which I already explained just now. This voltage is going to depend upon the doping concentration of the charge carriers in p and n region. This statement gives an idea how the Zener diode is constructed. By adjusting the doping concentration in p region and n region, the breakdown voltage of the diode, p-n junction diode, is made very sharp and distinct. Then that p-n junction diode, having very sharp and distinct breakdown voltage, is referred as the Zener diode. So friends, thus Zener diode has a very sharp and distinct breakdown voltage. This property is first given by Clarence E. Zener in 1938. Hence that diode is called as the Zener diode. Zener diode is always used in reverse bias condition. Zener diode works either in Zener effect or avalanche effect. Friends, we are now going to study what is mean by Zener effect and what do you mean by avalanche effect. Let me begin with the Zener effect. Dear students, when electric field produced across the p-n junction diode in reverse bias condition is very high, the supplied battery voltage is very high, very large, then due to a reverse external voltage which exerts the force on electrons of outermost cell, which will break the covalent bond and makes it free for conduction. Means the reverse voltage, high reverse voltage that is applied across the p-n junction diode, exert the force on the outermost orbit of this cell, outermost orbit of the atom, so as to break the covalent bond and makes the electrons free for the conduction. This is due to the electrostatic force of attraction. This increases free charge carriers to increase the current, is known as the Zener effect. Very simple aspect, when externally supplied voltage becomes very very high, it will exert the force on the outermost cell of an atom, which will break the covalent bond and makes the free electrons, and we know that when the electrons are made free, it is going to conduct the current. This effect is known as Zener effect. The diodes having the breakdown voltage less than 6 volt works with the Zener effect. But remember, the diode having the voltage less than breakdown voltage 6 volt means that the p-n junction diode which has a sharp breakdown voltage less than 6 volt. Means what? 3.2 volt, 3.8 volt, 3.6 volt, 4.2 volt, 4.8 volt, 5.2 volt, 5.8 volt, 6 volt. Such a diodes with their breakdown voltages are referred to work under the Zener effect. Now let me understand the avalanche effect. This is the effect that takes place after the Zener effect. Means Zener effect is a part of avalanche effect. After the Zener effect, the electrons generated in the Zener effect are accelerated by the external battery applied voltage or by the field due to increasing reverse voltage. Means reverse applied voltage is increased even after the Zener effect. Then what happens is these electrons with high speed collides on the atoms to dislodge the further electrons. Means after Zener effect, whatever electrons which are generated, they will be accelerated due to increasing external much more voltage, and they will allow to collide on the atoms of the semiconductor, which will dislodge the further electrons. If you increase the further external voltage, so generated more electrons will be further accelerated. Again, they will collide and generate the more and more electrons. This, the avalanche of electrons are generated, and the Zener diode starts conducting the current. This effect is called as the avalanche effect. After Zener effect, electrons are accelerated by the external field. They will collide on the atoms of the semiconductor and dislodges the free electrons. These dislodged free electrons are further accelerated, again collide on the atoms of the semiconductor, and again dislodges the free electrons. And thus avalanche of electrons are produced for the conduction. And the voltage at which this effect takes place, it is also called as the breakdown voltage. If the Zener diode works with this particular effect, then it is called as an avalanche Zener diode. And if the Zener diode works only with the Zener effect, it is simply called as Zener diode. The Zener diode having the breakdown voltage greater than 6 volt are called as avalanche Zener diode. Means avalanche effect takes place with the breakdown voltage more than 6 volt. Zener effect takes place with the breakdown voltage less than 6 volt. Dear students, this is the symbol that represents the Zener diode. This flat surface is called referred as anode. This represents the cathode. It is always used in reverse bias. Means to the cathode, positive terminal of the battery is connected. To the anode, negative terminal of the negative terminal of the battery is connected, and applied voltage is increased either up to 6 volt if it is a diode working with the Zener effect, or it will be more than 6 volt if the Zener diode is working with the avalanche effect and made it to be conducting. That sharp breakdown voltage makes the PN junction, simple PN junction diode, to be converted into the Zener diode. Dear students, let me study the IV characteristics of Zener diode. Friends, we know that the Zener diode will be made to work only in the reverse bias condition. And that's why we are going to study only reverse IV characteristics of Zener diode. The circuit diagram used to plot the current voltage characteristics of Zener diode is represented here. This circuit diagram is same as that of the circuit diagram that we have used to plot the IV characteristics of simple PN junction diode. There is nothing difference in that particular circuit diagram and this particular circuit diagram, only with the fact that there is a simple PN junction diode, but now we have used the Zener diode. Symbolically, just we have represented. With that particular aspect, we can say the circuit diagram to plot the IV characteristics of Zener diode consists of consists of a power supply or battery whose positive terminal is connected to the fixed terminal of the rheostat. Negative terminal is connected to the another fixed terminal of the rheostat with the key K. Whereas that negative terminal is made common throughout the circuit. This is the common one. The variable terminal of the rheostat is connected to the positive terminal of the voltmeter, whereas the negative terminal of the voltmeter is connected, made common. Same positive terminal is connected over the positive terminal of the current meter with current limiting resistor to protect the zero diode against the excess of heavy current. Negative terminal of the connector is connected to the negative terminal of the zener diode, whereas the positive terminal, positive region of the zener diode is grounded. Across the zener diode, there is a load resistance connected. Across load resistance, output voltage to be measured by means of an output voltmeter is connected. Friends, look at here. This is the negative terminal of the zener diode. It is connected to variable of the rheostat via some measuring devices to the positive terminal of the battery. Means negative terminal of the zener diode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery, and positive terminal of the zener diode, that is anode, is connected to the negative terminal of the battery. That makes the zener diode to work in reverse bias condition. Now we have to take the readings. As we have operated the circuit to plot the IV characteristics of simple PN junction diode. Here, by using this rheostat, variable rheostat, vary the pointer so that this voltmeter will start indicating the deflection. Try to increase the voltage and note down the current flowing through the zener diode. This is the input voltage that represents, whereas this one represents the output voltage. Friends, we are interested to measure the output voltage and that of the output current. So this is the current and this is the voltage we have to measure. So increase the input voltage and try to measure the output voltage by using output voltage voltmeter and output current meter. Naturally, plot the graph of output voltage versus output current for constant load resistance. Or you fix the input voltage by using the rheostat and then vary the load resistance, that is resistance box, and note down current and voltage. By changing the load resistance RL, we have the set of readings of output current and that of the output voltage. Then plot the graph of output current IO or IL versus output voltage VO or VR. This is the nature of the graph that represents. This graph has the same nature as that of the reverse characteristics of simple PN junction diode. Then what is the difference? Difference is that this particular voltage, to which we can call it as, it is a zener breakdown voltage. This zener breakdown voltage is very sharp and distinct. That is the speciality. From the nature of the graph, we can say at the beginning, when voltage is zero, current is zero. Increase in reverse voltage
increases the current with a slow rate exactly at breakdown voltage, either by avalanche effect or by Zener effect, there is a sudden rise in output load current that takes place. The minimum reverse voltage at which junction will break down and further it undergoes either Zener effect or avalanche effect to allow current to increase due to the minority charge carriers, that voltage is known as breakdown voltage of the Zener diode. Friends, nowadays in a market, Zener diodes are available with the variety of the breakdown voltage. As per requirement of our power supply, that Zener voltage is being chosen. These are available, as I explained, that 3.2 volt, from 3.2 volt up to even 9.8 volt. Below 6 volt, there is a Zener effect. Above 6 volt, there is an avalanche effect. So that explains again the working of the Zener diode. So here the voltage remains constant throughout, even though load resistance is increased, or even though input voltage is increased, again voltage remains constant. That is the speciality of the Zener diode. Once the voltage becomes equal to breakdown voltage, after that voltage, output voltage doesn't increases, output voltage remains constant, but current starts increasing. This peculiar property of the Zener diode having the sharp and distinct breakdown voltage in reverse bias diode can be used as a voltage regulator. Whenever the power supplies are going to be get generated, and if you connect the Zener diode across that, it will provide the fixed voltage for the further output load. That is the one and only one application of the Zener diode, and that it can be used as the voltage regulator. Dear students, the graph is represented, third quadrant indicates that it is operated in reverse bias region. So these are the some data given in forward bias condition, because we are not using the diode in forward bias condition. Try to forget this. This is important for us. That is known as reverse IV characteristics of Zener diode. This is the minimum Zener current, whereas this one is the maximum Zener current. So this is how the Zener diode works, and this is how one can plot the IV characteristics, which by observing it, one can interpret the working of, again, the Zener diode. Dear students, Zener diode has got only one application, and that is, it is going to be used as a regulator to provide a constant output voltage to the load. That is the only one application of the Zener diode. It has a very sharp and distinct breakdown voltage. It will work either Zener effect or avalanche effect. These are its specialties or the special characteristics. Student friends, that's all about the Zener diode. Zener diode is an extension of the simple p-n junction diode, which will be constructed by adjusting only the doping concentration in p region and n region so as to make it to work in either Zener effect zone or in the avalanche effect zone, but so as to give very sharp and distinct breakdown voltage. Such a special diode, we can call it as, it is the Zener diode. Student friends, that's all about the Zener diode. Next time we will go for one more special diode known as light emitting diode.